Children, welcome to Sacred School Study Help. I am Sahadev Jena, your MSc teacher. Today I am going to teach MSc for Standard 5, Lesson 1, You Are Precious. Please listen carefully. Now I am going to explain the lesson. Santosh and Jaya were happy children. They were born in middle class family in Chennai. Their father worked in a college as a professor and their mother in a school as a teacher. The children lived with their parents and grandparents in an apartment. Santosh was studying in class 10 and Jaya was in class 5. Jaya's classmate Steffi moved to their new home in the same apartment. A week back, Steffi had one of her legs a bit twisted from her birth. She could walk slowly with her right hand supporting her leg. She was always helped to carry her school bag and lunch kit. Jaya now took it as her duty to help Steffi on her way to school and back home. Jaya used to entrust her bag to her brother and wait at the door of Steffi in the morning to help her. They traveled in the same school bus. Things became easy for Steffi as Jaya was so generous, helping her all the time at home and in the school. Jaya's parents took pride in the spontaneous support of Santosh and Jaya to Steffi. Jay Lovelet Crawford presented a new vision to our eyes through the poem, The World is Mine. One day the poet saw a lovely maid in a bus. The pretty girl had golden hair. She was immensely happy and cheerful. People almost envied her beauty and cheerfulness. The poet thought that she could be as pretty as this maid. She rose to get down at her stop. When the bus stopped, she wore her crutch and limped down the steps. The people understood that she had no foot and wore a crutch to walk. She gave a pleasing smile to people in the bus as she left. The poet said, "Oh God, forgive me when I whine. I have 2 feet. The world is mine." The poet then stopped in a shop to buy some sweets. She saw a charming boy selling sweets. She spoke to him kindly. The charming boy said, "It is so wonderful to talk with people like you. But you see, I am blind and I can't see you." The poet felt sorry for the blind boy. She came out of the shop thinking, "Oh God, forgive me when I whine. I have 2 eyes. The world is mine." She then walked down the street. She saw a child with blue eyes. He was watching the other children playing on the street. It looked as if he did not know the game and was not taken into play. She waited there for a moment and observed. Then she asked, "Why don't you join with others, dear?" But he looked straight and went away without a word to her. When he did not respond to her, she understood that he could not hear. She said sadly, "Oh God, forgive me when I whine. I have 2 ears, the world is mine." The poet then felt that she was blessed in many ways. She had 2 legs to carry her wherever she wanted to go. She could jump, run, and leap. She had 2 eyes to see the sunset beauty. She could see the beauty of the nature and all the wonderful things around. She had 2 ears to hear the eternal music. She could hear all what people spoke, the sound of the rolling waves and the chirping of the birds. But she felt bad that she was complaining all the time. She asked God to forgive her for the time she was complaining. With more hope and courage, she said, "I blessed indeed. The world is mine." My dear children, here I have given some homework for you. MSc, Lesson 1, You are Precious. Answer the following. What did the poet and the other people in the bus came to know about the pretty maid? The poet and the other people in the bus came to know the pretty maid had golden hair. What did the poet find in the charming boy in the sweet stall? The poet found in the charming boy in the sweet stall that he was blind and he cannot see. What did the poet understood from the child with the blue eyes? The poet understood from the child with the blue eyes that he could not hear. Why did the poet ask God to forgive her? The poet asked God to forgive her because he was always complaining to God. How will you react when you see a physically handicapped person? When I see a physically challenged person, I would help him to cross the road. B. Find the missing letters. Heart, ability, precious, character, personality. Write the correct statement. The pretty girl was not happy and cheerful. The pretty girl was happy and cheerful. Jaya Lovelet was deaf and dumb. Jaya Lovelet was not deaf and dumb. Our prime duty is to ignore the body. Our prime duty is to care the body. The poet was not blessed in many ways by God. The poet was blessed in many ways by God. Our human body does not do innumerable function. Our human body does innumerable functions. Now D, fill in the blank. Steffi had one of her legs a bit twisted from her birth. Number 2. Beautiful life is the greatest gift of God. Our prime duty is to take care of our body. Number 4. The poet wanted to be as pretty as the maid. Number 5. Your inner qualities and character make you great. My dear children, please study well, work hard, don't waste your time. May God bless you. Thank you.